Well, tonight, parts of eastern Oklahoma are still iced over, leaving behind dangerous conditions for drivers. 4029's Joe Ellison joins us live in Salisaw, where the winter blast hit first. And Joe, how are conditions out there tonight?
Well, Highway 59 and Interstate 40 all the way to Fort Smith, you have clear roads there. Now it's heading west where drivers are running into the problem. Some parts of Interstate 40 are iced over, but it's the rural roads here in Sequoyah County that have kept these kids out of school for 3 days.
I'm ridiculously slick. I guess my friend she tried to gas it coming up and she slid, and this is what happened.
Christina Crowder came to this rural road near Vianne to help pull her friend out of a ditch.
No damage to my friend, so we're good.
Good. From Gore to Gans, the roads seem to be the same. With around 600 miles of rural roads in Sequoyah County, Emergency Management Coordinator Chris Keithley says the roads just aren't safe for anyone.
Well, you know, that's just it. With all the rain that we got, you know, it's a solid sheet of ice. I mean, as you can see here, you know, it's... School buses can do good as long as it's flat. But as soon as they get on any type of incline at all, they're going to spin, slide to the side, and then there they are in the ditch with a busload of kids with 14 degrees.
Crews have spent the last 3 days trying to break through the ice.
All the districts sanding and trying to stay ahead of it, but, you know, there's just only so much you can do.
Keithley says it may just have to melt away eventually.
Because with these temperatures staying below zero most of the time, or like right today, 14 degrees, it ain't going to thaw.
Now, luckily, people here in Sequoyah County haven't had a major problem with any major power outages. But with these slick roads, buses like CATS haven't been running. They are running today, though. We did hear from the sheriff's department that a 911 call came in yesterday from some people who needed a ride to the local Walmart here to get some food. Of course, emergency management coordinator took them, and they're okay today. And those bus services are back up and running today. Reporting live in Sequoyah County, I'm Joe Ellison, 4029 News.
Okay, Joe, thank you.